When you want to see a doctor, you have to ask for an appointment. For each doctor's appointment, it is important for you to arrive on time, but it is best to arrive 15 minutes early. If you are late or you miss your appointment, the doctor will probably not be able to see you since they have to see other patients on that day. If you cannot go to your appointment, call their office a day before, or as soon as you find out you cannot make it, to cancel. Work with the person from the doctor's office to schedule another time with the doctor when you are free. If you need help, call your case manager and they can help you reschedule the appointment and teach you how to if you are not sure. In many primary care offices, you will need to first walk to the front desk and let them know you are there to see the doctor. This is what is known as check-in. During check-in, they will ask for your name and date of birth. You can tell them the language you would like to speak during the appointment so they can use an interpreter at no cost to you. Clinics use trained medical interpreters, usually on the phone, who are required to keep all conversations private or confidential, which means they are not allowed to share your information with others. Medical clinics can also sometimes have in-person interpreters provided by the medical insurance. Medical clinics are not allowed to have children interpret for you, and only in certain situations can an adult family member or friend interpret for you. While speaking to the person at the check-in desk, let them know if you prefer to see a male or female doctor. That way, they can do their best to prepare for your preferences when it is possible. Language and gender considerations are in place so both you and your doctor are free to talk about your health in a private and open way, while fully understanding each other's advice and concerns. The person working at the front office will have you read and sign some forms. One of these forms will be a consent to treat form, which gives the clinic staff permission to meet with you and evaluate your health condition. They will ask for your insurance card, picture identification, and if you have brought any of your health information, such as a biodata form, or your overseas medical report and medication list. This is helpful to your doctor to see your medical history. They will ask you for other information, such as how to reach you by phone, your address, and a person they can call if they cannot talk to you by phone. They will also have you complete a form that says you received a handout on privacy information and that your health information cannot be shared with others. All these steps are helpful for you and your doctors to ensure information is shared correctly. Recap: arrive for your appointment 15 minutes early, if possible. Always stop by the front desk to check in and get any forms you need to sign. Bring the following: your picture ID card, your insurance card, or the card for the person seeing the doctor, overseas medical records for the first appointment, and a list of medications and herbs you are taking. Make sure you tell the front desk what language you are most comfortable speaking in. That way, they can ensure there is a medical interpreter during your appointment. The clinic might have options for medical interpreters such as the phone, video, and/or in-person interpreter. Ask the front desk what their options are and choose the one you prefer. Do not rely on family and children to be your interpreters. Trained interpreters are helpful because they have learned medical terms the doctor uses and can share them in your language fluently. Ask questions whenever you are unsure or do not understand. After you have completed and returned the forms to the front desk, you will sit in the waiting room until your name is called. The medical staff calling your name will take you back to the examination room. While waiting for the doctor, the medical assistant might get some of your health measurements, such as your weight, height, blood pressure, and temperature. At a primary care office or family doctor clinic, you can see a doctor for many reasons. When you are feeling sick, needing medicine refills, have diabetes, heart conditions, lack of sleep, aching muscles, and need an annual checkup. An annual checkup is a visit that happens once a year, regardless if you are feeling well or feeling a bit sick. This appointment is helpful so you can talk to your doctor about how your health is, check how your body is feeling if you have been sick, get immunization updates, and discuss any healthy habits. The doctor will ask you why you are at the appointment and then ask you questions about symptoms and your medical history. Use this time to share your experience with the doctor freely. The doctor might choose to do a physical exam if necessary. The doctor might run other tests as well. The doctor, nurse, or medical assistant might ask additional questions, including if you feel safe at home, if you feel sad or are not sleeping well, have a history of falling, and other questions related to your health. The doctor might keep notes on a computer during the visit. You will spend at least 15 minutes or more with the doctor. It is okay to ask your doctor questions about your health and the plan you will both use to make you feel better. After your visit with the doctor is over, they might ask you to get blood work done. That appointment is at a lab and is helpful to the doctor and you to have an in-depth look at your health. Some doctor's offices have a lab in the same building, or you may have to go to a different location to a lab. You might hear some people refer to the lab with a specific name. Ask the doctor or case manager what the name of the lab is if you are unsure. At times, the doctor could recognize that you might need medication to treat an illness. If you do need medication, the doctor will write a note called a prescription. Most prescribed medications will be sent to a pharmacy directly by the doctor's office. If you are comfortable, let your case manager know you have a prescription or need to go to the pharmacy after your appointment. Please note, if your primary care doctor wants you to be seen by a specialist, they will send over some of your health information so that doctor has enough information to evaluate your needs. A specialist is a doctor that focuses on a specific part of the body. This process is called a referral, when your doctor makes a request for you to see another doctor for a specific health need. There are other times when your doctors can share your health information with others. For court orders, switching to a new doctor, for emergencies, and this includes if you have thoughts of wanting to harm yourself or harm someone else. Recap. The appointment with the doctor is around 15 minutes. Take the time to share how your body feels with the doctor. Doctors and nurses take notes to make sure they remember what you say so that they can make the best recommendation for your treatment. To get a detailed look at your health, doctors might recommend blood work. The blood work can be done in a lab. The doctor will share the results of the lab test/blood work during your next appointment. To treat some illnesses, a doctor might recommend medication. The medication recommended by a doctor is called prescribed medication or prescription. Prescribed medication is picked up at a pharmacy. After your appointments are over, the doctor will share what they find out about your health and discuss their recommendations. They will also let you know what the next steps are for you to stay healthy or feel better. This next step can include seeing a specialist for further care. If you have any questions about your health, please ask your doctor or the nurse in the room during your appointment.